I don't know. I was just messing around with programming this.
Wait, and Charlie.
Testing it to see if it stops working.
Oh yeah.
You have no right.
Oh yeah. Well, that's.
It's like your arm. It's just like
one step ahead. I was actually looking up cardboard cutouts. They're more expensive than I thought. But the cheapest one I could find was me putting my face in one direction for $20. But then I was thinking we can just take whole body
monitors. You have any for open suit? And you should think of something, some way that you can show your if you wanted to show any videos or anything. Yeah.
Sure.
You know, if you have a way of showing some of your video stuff on a wall, that would be a good idea.
I got it
in
here.
But
wouldn't you need more than
there's a lot of walls.
Yeah. I mean, I guess I could.
You can open your space.
Yeah, I just did it under. You can turn shit around, but I could. I have to see it all the time.
Not really.
Who ever stole?
I guess. You don't have, you can't, lock anything. Well, you could close it, you could have it open. You can have it outside of your room, And you can have your room open when you're in there and not open when you're not in there.
That makes sense, You can come to the robot beds today.
I wanted to. I locked my keys in my car, so I had to go to Braintree, get my keys. How was it?
It was pretty good. Yeah,
I wish there was a guy in there trying to avoid it.
One of them lit on fire.
Yeah.
Ooh.
It was a small fire.
I wish no one put it out.
Why can't we ever have fun?
I wish the whole
thing was burned. That wasn't even there.
Oh, I don't want to
get distracted. This tape has a lot of. This is when you really should pay attention to it. The AK one went on forever and was painful. This one, listen to the whole argument all over again. It's endless.
Yeah.
It's my Charlie's Kitchen masterpiece.
Nice.
Oh, yeah.
Look at that. We put it in.
I
don't know who wrote it.
I should call her Brain Train friend,
Yeah. Bring that LSD for our lesbian. He's gonna spike that around.
Oh my god. Yes.
I saved him in my phone as another freight train. Yeah, and that's when he gets really serious. I bet 50 years are lost. He kept showing us his Christmas.
Who are you talking about?
This guy that was my new biggest fan, this guy that was at Charlie's Kitchen.
Yeah,
he just comes up and give me your number. Play Jersey.
Yeah.
You did not play.
Yeah. He's on Facebook Live.
Yeah, you should see. And then he was spitting around.
Yeah,
yeah, he hops.
He spits some rhymes for us.
He hops freight trains, but he really.
Freight train brother.
What was the tag? And then he sent you a tag. Really great to experience.
You're
supposed to go,
well,
this guy. I did?
Uh-huh.
What do you mean?
I left the church!
What did I see? Yeah, we were just talking about that. So it must be in weird ways that other people can see me. What did I text back? Fuck that guy! I hope he's dead!
Yeah, basically. I was whoa!
Who is this? What are you talking about?
She's saying I was angry at this. She sent me a screenshot of us two talking. I was probably meant it a joyous way, I want to be the joy. If my anger must come out in the ways I know.
I must black out sometimes. Full of anger.
Yeah.
So the guy, he was a freight train operator, and he did 58 fast.
Yeah, well, but then we told him to come to the radio show.
You were saying, 5 a.m., what the fuck is wrong with me?
Yeah.
Texted at
5 a.m.
What the fuck is wrong?
Oh, now see, I'm the happiest, go luckiest guy. I was just quoting you. I was quoting your anger. catchphrase is what the fuck
now
is
that was direct at
me. Now you caught me! You idiot!
What if I have mad right now?
I don't say that. I never say you idiot.
No, I'm trying to be me getting angry.
Oh, you're trying to be you. I'm sorry.
And
no,
yeah,
I'm
not
a good ex.
Yeah. Why don't you want to extend it into my friends?
Okay. That's sad.
Now, I don't know what to write down for all this.
This sent? Someone tell Tyrone that we're here because I'm not sure if my message is sending.
I think send a message where you at. I wouldn't mind my message is also not sending. Is there like no signal there? Bad signal?
Well, we're getting the Wi-Fi.
Okay. Which one?
You gotta
Which Wi-Fi do you get back?
Wi-Fi.
Wow.
It's just wire that's fire.
Oh,
what does it stand for? I never knew. I have that confession. Wi-Fi joke. We always make Banjo tell the joke when you get when you cross an elephant and a rhino and a rhino, but I don't think she ever understood what she was saying. No harm. And I got a best brother in the world.
You miss your karate part.
It's Taekwondo!
It's Enter the Dragon.
Oh! Hey, that one sounds. Okay. Well, it says send it.
You ever work one of those men?
I'm just gonna keep saying why do I do that? WYA.
I don't know if you started,
dyslexic.
I thought it was fun.
I wasn't always dyslexic, but I've turned dyslexic.
Oh, well, turnt is in right now.
I know, but is dyslexia.
It's the new Corona. Oh, is dyslexia.
Maybe I'll just call him.
Yeah.
So, But I really want to make a robot.
June 3rd, you need a bot.
You need a bot by June 3rd. Is that...
That's the show. But yeah, I'm thinking cardboard cutout.
Well, do we want to make your chin go?
Yeah, but I mean, of course you wanted to do everything, but it's what is possible.
Well, I think you can make it thicker, bigger, like creepy chin.
Yeah.
Amazing.
Yeah, I'm trying to think. Maybe we can get some hair too.
Yeah.
I think some of our strings.
Well, somebody else can harvest it.
Okay. And then I was thinking we could have like little light bulbs in your eyes that go off when you make noise.
Just like the real thing.
Exactly. Yeah, a live microphone. Because it says on the Facebook page, feature Jarl in. Really
got to
be.
Robot form.
I can't wait
to get
promoted.
Just live. What is this? These are your set times? Okay,
yeah.
Be very careful.
Well, I'll do this anything that great.
I mean, I guess But what if the cords were made of rock now? I've already had them. Damn. Just checking. Stuff I've had.
Back to my art.
I think the other half of this, is labeled.
One step ahead.
Oh, what's the other side?
Pittsburgh. This is the blank side.
Oh, good morning.
You know who I ran into the other day? Ricky Trevor Scott.
Has he been around a lot?
Just stop?
His last name is Discovery. His last name is
Discovery. Oh, yeah, but I don't recognize him. Toscano.
Yeah.
So if you see an art piece by Grace and Trevor, I just put him on all the AMF on the studios. I don't know if he wants to be. Although, like, I think he does sign, but. Toscano. But I've literally never said that
before.
Toscano?
I never said it until Scooter Boy 1.
The original.
The original.
And he's only walking in the hall. And he was like, it's a Toscano. It's a Toscano.
That's like, what?
Sounds like a pasta.
He's like,
yeah,
it's a Toscano.
Can you
eat it? Got my mom's plate.
No.
Oh,
no touching!
That's what I know I'm gonna observe that he's doing.
Plus, we gotta take that shelf apart.
What?
Yeah. Which one? So, you're gonna have to take all that stuff off.
Well, I'm gonna enjoy it.
And remember how I told you that your display's gonna be up there?
Dude, this isn't like
not there.
I just have gathered, like, now.
Well, you're gonna have to dismantle all of them.
Or whatever.
He talks about how much he doesn't want to talk about it.
have like a screenplay that he was writing that was based on it, but that actually like happened like seamlessly. It like as he was telling the story, what actually happened, so I wasn't really sure what he was telling me was true. Yeah. Oh yeah, this screen book that he's writing.
We all have a freak.
Show
now.
Me the book. Show me that script, Joe.
So he
keep talking about it.
I never get an answer about how he fell off.
It's not that long. I kinda wanna get the truth is, like I bet the guys that he doesn't know. Well, I bet there's some like articles about it.
Oh, he said that.
He always talks about it. Why didn't you hear the Mariah part? I feel like I'm just speaking all of you to talk and about how I'm a knucklehead.
I would like to see or to know what happened.
Yeah, someone I never get a straight answer. I just want to say, what were you doing on the roof at the hotel?
He said it was a
birthday. Oh, I thought it was a holiday inn for some reason.
Holiday.
Why did I think it was a holiday?
Maybe he was talking about a
spoon. Maybe that's the version.
That might be the real freak show.
So, I mean, I'd still be willing to do it, but...
Still be willing to do what?
We've been trying forever to make a schedule, because remember when Sterling yelled at him on the phone?
Yeah.
Sterling's like, not a very organized person, so they said, we're going to do it. So then that's the time you saw me. And then a few weeks after that, we were at the improv and we saw Sterling. She was like, didn't you say 2 weeks ago you're going to have that schedule done? And then, no, we're doing that. But, so yeah, well, all we know is we're seeing first.
Yeah, it's also he's convinced that he, that I dyed my hair for his movie.
Yeah.
Tells people that like he told me to dye my hair and so I just did because he told me to.
Right.
And it's like, I don't know, it's kind of crazy.
Oh, my mom on the show.
I don't
like,
think Tyrone or Steven understands the reality of your feelings about that. Because I kind of know that because Steven told me about it.
Yeah.
But in Steven's story, it's that your dad didn't like your hair or something, and then Tyrone was like,
oh, yeah, the first thing
it's for my movie.
And then Tyrone said, I don't like your hair or something. I just said to dye it for the movie. And then Steven was like, I don't know, this looks like that you were upset about that. And I was like, why would Maddie care whether
no, that was like a different
all turned to dye her hair.
I was just telling that story to, because somebody asked me how my dad felt about Tyrone. And so I told them, like, my dad came home for the first time in like months. I hadn't seen him, and so he came home and he was like, and he was like, oh, like, your hair is different. And I said, yeah. And then Tyrone started telling him, like, yeah, she dyed her hair for my movie, The Freak Show, Sir. And then my dad walked away from him without, like, acknowledging that he had spoken to that, like, he didn't ask, like, what's up, what's The Freak Show? He was kind of, like, carried on about his business because he had, like, he doesn't know how this is doing. And so, that was, like, the whole point of that story, is that my dad feels nothing about Tyrone.
So
Tyrone's
still
living
in your house?
Yeah.
Your dad?
Yeah.
Just
well,
my dad's
it's like,
yeah,
no,
heart
it's,
to heart.
That's actually, it's funny because nothing. He has not said anything.
Does he ever say to you, like, your friend Tyrone?
No, he says that, or he just, like, doesn't register. He doesn't want, I know that he doesn't want him there, but I know that he doesn't want to say anything about it because he doesn't want to argue. Happening. So he just like doesn't acknowledge that he's there. So he's just there. And my dad just like walks around. Yeah. He'll like come say hi or like are you, you know, he'll start talking. He like wanted to talk to him about his movie, and my dad just ignored that he had said anything. It's just.
Is he like looking in the eye or what?
No, it's like he, like mid sentence, he'll walk away and say something. But like he's happy when he's like talking to me and he's not angry or like ignoring him and being like mad. He's just ignoring him because he doesn't want to deal with the situation. Where he has somebody living in his house who's a stranger, and he doesn't want them to be there. So he just, it's just easier for him to, like, not acknowledge
but
that it's happening.
But you can't tie around for using
it. What's he doing? No, he'll never, I mean, it's like, I kind of want to see, like, how far I can push him in until he finally acknowledges his presence. But it has to happen. Like, he gave him a ride to the team once. And, oh, and when Tyrone got out of the car, he went like this to me, and so I did it back. And then I said to my dad, it was from Barry Gordy, the last match, and he didn't say anything.
Your dad?
Yeah. He, like, didn't know about it.
No,
but he was
but
like,
the
what is that? So normally he talks, like, when it comes to Tyrone, he's in the car. Yeah, and he'll talk to me about the weather, and he'll talk to me in front of Tyrone. And like, you know, about my schedule.
Never said anything to Tyrone at all. Never been like, hi, Tyrone.
I think he said hi, and then she just handed it,
like, ignored him. But what was your conversation like on the radio?
Talk to your dad about Tyrone? Are you like, why?
Why, except for when I said it's for Barry Gordy's The Last Fragment, and he just like, that was it. Was the 10th of high? No. It's easier to say. Because I'm not arguing with him about it. He's not saying, like, when is Tyrone moving out? I'm saying, I don't know.
How long have your dad
never been? Indefinitely, like,
maybe. So is Tyrone until
like,
someone stops.
Until the, like, fall, probably. Like, probably until September.
doesn't ask about it at all. Like,
talking about Tyrone and Maddie's gags.
My mom told him. But he didn't, like, call me and ask me about him. Is he your dad acknowledging you? Steve doesn't come over to my house.
But I'm
oh, really?
Like, talk.
You're afraid of Maddie's dad.
Not
that
I'm
afraid of Maddie's dad. Why is it weird?
But if you two ever, like, had a conversation.
It's also like...
You and Maddie's dad?
Not really. See, some of that was going on. He's a very quiet guy. Who does he talk to?
He talks to your mom.
He talks to me. Apparently
like,
not.
He's kind of in a...
I think you guys are defending yourself.
I mean, I
would
say I didn't.
What was the first time you met him, buddy? What about what I want to hear about that?
What happened?
Yeah, tell the whole story.
He didn't get a cigar guy. Oh, yeah, it was almost you just take me home. We have an 8 more. It's in the building. Like, the guy who's from New York, please, and like, owns all the infrastructure and the internet in the city.
Yeah.
Anyway,
I think
kind of
killed
him because
he was on the
roof. Yeah, we could push him off the roof. Steve was taking the internet down. I was thinking about it because I was kind of angry. I think it was sucking up to the search thing. But anyway, that's all kind of unrelated.
But so they, like, we didn't have enough cigars when we left, and
yeah.
So my dad went out and got cigars and he wanted to meet us there, and so Steve came down the stairs to meet my dad to get the cigars and bring them back the stairs.
Yeah,
and my dad, he gets flustered in traffic.
And I was trying to tell him where I was. Well, I really let him eat it. I don't know where the
main
entrance is! Okay, buddy, it's so much for you. I'll walk the other way. But then he saw me in person. And he was like, oh, sorry.
So that was that before you ever met him then?
Is he singing the song?
I think
you probably may have been. Right?
Why is it weird for Steve to be around or come over? Because I'm just like that's weird that I'm around because I also like there are just things that are too different for him to ask me to do emotionally that I don't want more people living in the house than yes or no, and I go, he's just like, please. But this is like, if he's even got over, I'd just be like, I have to ignore him. Huh? I don't think I'm overly good, like, I have to ignore him. Yeah. Well, he was like, kind of, and so, like, if he was hungry and he wanted to make a sandwich, he wouldn't.
I would love for Tyrone to be like full
but
Tyrone.
But so it's his house.
Like,
you
just
like,
legend.
I just
I love a long bug if you want to be single and dragging.
Yeah.
Be that cowabunga.
Like, my dad is like a weird guy. Yeah. But he has my mom is weird, but like in a way, she'll attract. Yeah, anybody.
Do you ever let
the drag car?
Do you ever let small things?
I could like break anyone. I've never had a spill sleep over my house, but I have had dinner with Phil's dad and he wanted to be a sleepover in my house. And he's got an extra bedroom between beds, so I could share with him. And his dad is like the Indian version of my dad, actually. It was really weird. But like having dinner with them was like having dinner with like my dad was just like solo dad. I imagine it would be starting to weird. It's really weird. Like a lot, like they're both mentioned.
I knew it. Oh, suck. See, just because you hate
that.
I think it's sums it up in that video. That was a puppy video of your dad. It was like, puppy poverty and walks away. That's all I've seen your dad. You sent me some video where like you and your
puppy
mom.
Party. Oh.
And then you go like, yeah, it's a puppy party. And you just copy. It was like, yeah, puppy party and like walks away. And I was thinking, like, well, this person sincerely made an effort. But you said it like so, like, yeah!
I know.
Like
it's
a little kid. It's like 90 seconds of, bro! It's like this time
go in, it's like a boot.
It's like, push, push, push. It's like, why breathe anymore?
Yeah.
It's like that.
Yeah.
Let's get
it. You just blow the way.
But it's extreme! They play the sound effects when you're in there. That's for the hurricane. No. Now you're gonna be that's what it does. Well, who needs that menopause anyway?
Turns your clock, your biological clock.
Let's turn it up to 100. They don't put mercury anymore, it's like cherry juice or something.
Quincy.com was his lifeline. He used to, he was working at SpaceX.
SpaceX, what is that?
It's the private satellite and rocket ship.
He drove a car without even being.
And now he's building the automated car to drive.
Yeah.
But he's big.
Very, very helpful. I mean, no one's Jarvis, ain't that?
Yeah, what we think
this
whole
psychology.
Oh, family shit. Yeah, maybe
I mean, he's fine. He's gotten better. He lives in California.
Oh, he didn't say that.
He's got a lot of harsh feelings towards me, though.
You would think you think anyone who does a criticism of you is autism. Oh, yeah, that is your autism.
Oh, don't worry.
He thought it wasn't my best show ever, but I feel sorry for his tendencies.
He came to a show at Out of the Blue, and he said that I was the best singer, my guitar was there. He had a critique.
Like, how would you want to share?
Well,
said I wasn't Jimi Hendrix.
That's what my family has always thought, like, that their best feedback is for them to compare me against everyone else. I'm like, the rap dude and whatever I'm doing, it's like competition.
My mom may have asked, was Maria better than Jarva?
Did she ask that?
Yeah,
she is. I wasn't expecting.
Everyone
tells
me she acts like the computer's against her. I'm trying to listen to Jarva. I saw it loading. I pressed.
I don't know.
Like, I never pressure to listen to it. Thank God I listen to Jarva.
Maria is better than Jarva. I thought about that too.
I was like, our art is now.
I really believe it is Maria.
She's like, would you see her if she wasn't your sister? My mom, like, desperately wanted to see her, but she won't leave the house.
She's never seen Maria.
No,
but if you told her Tyrone.
I know. I thought Tyrone would go that day.
She could give him a ride.
I could drive on both. Yeah. My mom won't even drive on a highway.
Oh.
Yeah, I know. It's brutal. But, well, for the first 2 years, she was in the van, like, every show. She's like, oh, we're going. I am going to set up the day.
I'm too old.
And, like, she has an art because I never pressure her to anything. She's like, I can't go, Niall. I can't go. She's the argument for herself. My dad has never went either. So it was, like, in an argument.
Really?
Yeah, my dad, because the thing is, like, I don't know, when it's on a Friday or a Saturday, and not too late, and then, like, I'll tease him and go, guess what, Maria's playing Saturday, she's on first, 7 p.m., and you'll have to, like, wait for a reason not to go, I don't know! And then my dad's creepy friend, Dave Packer, kind of crushed on my dad, he almost wants to see Maria play, and I kept teasing him, yeah, it's going to be really sad if Dave Packer sees your dog's play before you.
And they have sexual.
That's true. He's my new Facebook friend.
Does Maria want your dad to go?
Like,
as she said, like, hi.
I can never tell when they're in an argument or not. Well, I think she at this point just, I don't care if you go or not. Because, like, for the first couple of years, it was always, they might show up tonight. Because, like, he was in a band forever, and he, like, thought he was going to make it. Like, that. Like, so he knows all about comedy. Maybe there's some jealousy thing or something. But he always, like, he sees videos and he's like, don't tell her because her boyfriend's in the band. Maria's way better than her boyfriend.
I thought that too. Not quite, but I thought this band is really good and Maria's the best part.
Because he has such, like, an anti-musical knowledge thing. He's like, I can't believe her boyfriend went to Berkeley. Maria's way better. And he even says, Maria can't even sing. Don't tell her that. I like people who can sing.
She can sing.
She can't. Well, she sings the way I like it too, just singing how you talk. Because the boyfriend, you know that guy Devendra Banhart?
Yeah.
I think the boyfriend Alex tries to sing just like him, but Maria
makes
a surreal voice.
Yeah, Maria's got a great.
Which I
was. Way of singing.
Yeah, he does sing just like that. Yeah. Yeah. Maybe he'll grow out of it.
But he's not bad.
No, I'm not good.
Has she ever has Maria ever done anything just herself?
I think she did one sitting. Some type of college, gender, something about people wanting equality.
What did you say when your mom asked you if Maria was better than Darla?
I didn't think I said you can't really compare. Which,
to Darla.
You don't know either because you don't care. We talk the most when I wake up from a nap.
Yeah,
that's what she has to be
She's
always been like, this cat. She's always like the most.
And she's petted you.
I killed
like, this cat is my favorite.
That's what she starts to.
I killed this fly 50 times. This cat is so fat.
Well, her thing is like, I think a fear of aging thing is like, our old dog who died when she was like 15, for like the last 7 years of the dog's life, my mom's going, she's so old!
That's what my
mom
produces, Chloe.
Yeah, how old is Chloe? Oh, it just happened.
Fuck! Every
time! My favorite was
she
did a red all over the room. That's from the first explosion. And the yellow on my laptop from
it's
the second
my work
one.
Shirt.
So if only you were wearing that blue dress from before.
Now that we must remedy. The rest of this shit.
No, the popcorn! Not the weed for the popcorn.
This is the vintage popcorn. No!
Quick!
Will not happen! I will
not
happen!
What can we do?
Gosh dang it!
We're gonna try to listen to this.
Did he get on you?
Yeah.
You did? I'm sorry. Give me a paper towel, canister.
Well, where's the department?
Wait,
the paper towel.
Wait.
You no. Said, well, what do you want?
I need it to be
we never stopped this place.
Boris. Okay.
Why were you sitting?
Watching away.
Probably. Boris.
Sitting on this blanket. I want this blanket.
Out of here! Thank God for that blanket.
One use for this blanket ever in life.
I'm sure it'll happen many more times. Now that's just disrespect. We did that. There was some hatred in that.
Oh my gosh. Look at this beautiful blue. Strong!
Look at that beautiful blue key.
Hey, it's not like I'm going to keep forever door me. I ain't going to sell you. I'm going to buy more of you.
Blue edition.
Blue edition, fabric pint. Put you in a safe space.
That was exciting. I've never really. It's like a fun game.
What?
I think we all kind of love it with that. Might have cleaned the
room.
All
of us, yeah.
All
I think some of us might not love it because some of us. Have left the building.
Afterwards, if I'm involved, I'm like.
I know who would love it, and he's not here.
I love it, but we're so angry.
But people don't understand. Like, it's like I know what actually hurts Tyra.
I know it's like people telling you like how to conduct your relationship. Like you gotta be as deep in it as.
Like, oh no.
Everyone is different.
Yeah,
when my mom said, like, I told Tyra, like, he should be mad at you. Why aren't you buying a state-of-the-art camera?
That's what?
I mean, that's what I feel like my mom was saying, because when my mom wrote to Tyra, yeah, you should be mad at Kyle. He's not committing to your movie.
True. I know. They understand each other, Tyra and your mom.
I mean,
have a common enemy.
They really would. I mean...
/ love interest.
Yeah. Obsession.
And it did.
Welcome. You wrong in an adorable way again today.
What do we love to hate about Pat?
I know everything. Happy town the way.
Easy answer, everything.
He's always fucking up. He's always mad. He's always.
Can we get him to stop sleeping?
I know.
How can we get you?
He'd be
so much better.
He needs to sleep.
He would just cut this out.
little, like, I remember the last time, and you're napping? Oh, no. And then I like, woke up 40 minutes later. Well, you didn't nap for too long.
I'm very impressed with that.
But I know. Well, I think I did something.
So, I have no traceable sleep schedule anymore, so.
But you say
no
you
one can make
that,
me feel bad about it. Huh?
But
I do.
But you say you never do the disgusting act.
I'm just bad. I just can't do it.
So, Thompson, we're not here to attack you. We're here to just come down on it.
I think I've tried.
I'm like, this
I used to be very, I'm like, scared, I'm just, it's unnatural.
Just like me and Papa.
Just like you and Papa.
It's unnaturally.
It's unnatural, but somehow it's right.
Somehow.
Sometimes nature gets in the way of what should be.
True.
And that's what I've learned from my
mom. Nature's never
from
allowed
mom
us
and Papa.
To get physical.
That's true.
My tongue would get stuck in that tooth gap.
One of what tooth gap?
In Tyrone's mouth, the one I've always looked in.
What? Which one? I don't see any
Isn't
tooth gap.
Missing a tooth on the lower?
On the lower. Oh,
yeah.
Okay. That's where you're putting your tongue out.
I
see. I see your game plan, Mama.
That's
how
I got a mouth
for me. I see where you're
that's
doing.
That's what I think whenever I look, like, what is something I'd stuck in? But so did Repo say anything about a few nights ago?
Wait, what was a few nights ago?
The night of Marie's show. Things got really weird.
No, I had a good car ride with him. Tom with him today, but he didn't bring it.
He didn't talk about me at all.
What happened?
I don't even know where to start and how much time you got. I don't know if he looks like that.
Maybe you're the drama.
That's what I'm thinking, but like I've been going over this in my head. Because you're like the one sane person in my life. I don't know if that's saying anything. You heard it here, folks. I don't even know where to start with Repo, but.
Start.
Alright, well, so yeah, we were hanging out at the Middle East. Of course, he came right after Maria's set, and he just got paid, so he's buying everybody drinks. He's like, especially this one girl he's really into. And so then I left to take pictures. I took all the pictures.
You did?
I did.
Oh, great, because you can see everything. Going down.
Well, I've got them by memory. And then so I come back at Meredith, you know, Maria's man. She's still there.
Meredith.
She's
I love
going,
her.
Yeah, I mean, she's going like, Repo is, she keeps going like, Rob is ready to go home. So obviously he tells me he spent over 100 at the bar. This is all prelude, and by the way. So where did I notice things were getting weird? Oh, so, So yeah, we're like standing at the middle. Oh yeah, that girl left in an Uber.
Wait, what are you talking about?
This is a weird incident I had with Rob a few nights ago. And then she handed me a cigarette, so I was pretending to smoke to look cool. I thought yeah, I mean it was lit, but I don't even think I smoked it right. He's like, oh man, you're natural. And, so then all of a sudden, ooh, we see Travis walking down the street.
Oh,
this
I have
This is all has nothing to do with anything, but it just sets the mood.
That is the best definition of Travis.
Yeah, and he's eating stuff out of a cup, and that's all I'm noticing.
That sounds like classic Travis.
So we're talking mostly about you.
Obviously. What else is there to talk about?
I know, and, So then this other guy, this like hip-hoppy guy, who's been like spitting rhyme in my face all night that I couldn't hear.
Literally spitting?
There, well, he was getting pretty close, and he was like singing over the band in my face, and...
What?
Like,
so
and the band would be playing
like, right
and
he
like,
oh, cool, some niggas. Okay, you need to calm it down with your feet touching. All right.
That was a take two. So anyway,
no more reenactments, please, and thank you.
And then,
proved to be too much for you.
I know. So then that guy's hanging around. And where did it go off? Oh, then they're like, Rainbow's going like, Travis, why don't you ever call me? Remember we used to hang out with Hannah and stuff? And then, like, as a joke, Rainbow traps me, but he gets some skin in his grab. He's like, Kyle, why didn't you save Hannah's life? Which is, like, kind of as a joke. And then he's like, I'm sorry to do that. Then he goes, actually, kind of felt good to do it. Then he does it again. You could have saved the girl. And then, like, Pan and Rainbow and this hip-hop guy talking. The guy's like, I didn't like that girl that Hayley off. Travis is just like staring and walks away.
He knows I have Harry Offense.
Yeah, and he.
And I'm trying to throw them in a rapid, right?
For the
summer. It takes time and effort.
I know. There's gotta be some vitamins or something.
Respect!
So, anyway.
I guess
so,
somebody's been like going all the CBS's and Raymond Cannon stealing the road game, like thousands of dollars for their offense.
We can only hope it's for their pits. How are they coming? That's not
nice.
Bad.
It's not, it's... Oh, it's gonna take a while. Yeah, that's a long time. But it keeps growing.
Well, what's
as
the last
long
night
as you don't say that, it keeps growing. I know that.
That's what I've heard.
I believe.
That's a tip. But so anyway... Okay. So yeah, so then we're just walking back to UF where we parked, and then that hip-hop you got is like following them, following me and Repo.
There you go.
Yes, I do. And then, so I don't know what we're talking about. It's like, that girl was a bitch. She didn't even like me, or something like that. And then, all of a sudden, I'm not. This is the exact quote, which shows that maybe I'm not in the wrong. Repo says to the guy, hey, do you have any drugs? And then the guy, like, once you said that to a drug dealer, yeah, the guy's like, lights up, yeah, I got everything. X, crack, heroin, and everything. Like, And then, like, Repo starts going, no, I shouldn't do that, because he owes me money. I shouldn't, this just adds insult. I shouldn't do that, because I owe you money, Kyle, so I spent the money I owe you. He goes, no, what are you doing? And then he's going, like, well, I have a drug test tomorrow. And the guy's like, no, you drink water, you piss water. And then we go, like, what kind of drugs he got? And, like, they're talking about, like, crystal meth and stuff. Like,
oh, that sounds good.
And then Lisa keeps going, like, come with me, Kyle. Get this guy a ride home. Come with me. And I'm going, like, you do what you want to do. I don't want to be involved in this. And we're, like, walking. And Repo keeps going, like, no, come with me. Like, you can do it. Give this guy a ride. And I'm, like, trying to go,
you
mom.
You can do it.
Yeah, and I'm going, like, well, he's got a drug test tomorrow. Why don't you two exchange
you
numbers? I guess to
it?
Get his, Suboxone, I think. Or
wait.
Whatever his heroin opiate blocker thing is.
Hey, you're not supposed to
tell
anybody about it.
Oh, sorry.
Remember that?
Well, you
and
did.
And it's not Suboxone. And I never told anybody.
Well, I never told it. What?
Okay.
I'm not saying you told anybody.
It's on YouTube, man.
Is this isn't live. It's like...
But it's gotta be.
Sorry.
Sorry.
So then that goes on a long time. And so then I'm just, like, I stay, like, an hour later than wanted to, so finally, in my, me and Reef have like a fake argument, and I'm in my car, and
fake
like,
argument?
Well, I can't tell what's real, then, like, when I'm driving away, he bangs on the window.
Red flag.
I know, for me.
Threw that in there,
the window. Oh, you guys didn't know, I don't know what's real.
I
so then,
last
like,
time I killed him, I thought I was playing with
I don't know.
Me, you took the drugs.
Then he bangs on the window.
I am Reef.
It's like, Kyle, no, I don't want to end on a bad note. Well, I can't tell if you're joking or not. He goes, of course I'm joking. I love you. Come here. Then, like, I drive away. And then I get a text later going, like, I thought you were, he'd say, I thought you were my friend. I was begging for help back there. Like, why? Because right when he left, like, him and the guy were, like, doing a drug deal in, like, the corner of EMF. He's going, like, I was, like, you should have made up a story. Like, I guess the whole time, in hindsight, he wanted me to, like, talk him out of doing drugs, even though he clicked, his exact quote was, do you have any drugs? And then I said, like, I don't know what, I texted back, like, I didn't get what was going on, and he wrote something like, you don't, there are things about life you don't understand, and then I was like, where are you now? And he was like, it doesn't matter, just next time be a friend or something like that.
What?
And then I was thinking maybe,
wait, so he's mad at you for not, like,
I've been thinking about this
constantly,
yeah, for like 2 days, like, who was in the wrong? And then, I was thinking maybe the next, because even the way he does it, he like kind of apologizes. He's like, not your fault, but you're not a good friend. I know you didn't know what's going on, but you weren't there for me. So I was thinking maybe the next day he'd, like, write me back more clear-headed, but it didn't.
Yeah, but then, sometimes he doesn't. Like, I can send you a text message you sent me, like, at that Dave Trees thing, but I'm like, I don't even know what you're talking about.
Yeah.
But then I was like, are you okay? He said he was coming to the radio show and he didn't come. And they texted me back after, like, I saw various Facebook stuff. But, like, 2 days later, like, yes!
Yeah, he slept in his cup.
Like, and I just never even addressed, like, the things. Like, I could read you.
Okay. So that's all between that and, like, repo.
Like,
so.
I would just talk to him in real life because
I know.
He'd get, you know,
so I was
like,
gonna come in this morning, but I was just so, like, who are these friends of ours? Like, I have every relationship in my life. But then I hear he's like defending me.
Yeah, I don't know. He thinks it's weird to me about, like, so. Yeah, we were talking about Joe's, like, how he says that he had sex with Drew Barrymore.
And how we should never talk
what?
About it.
And yeah, and then how
know?
We should never talk about
he
it.
He brings up Drew Barrymore and says, why are you talking about this
yeah.
shit?
Yeah.
So
and so then
true.
I told
him. He's never told
me.
I told
him. You have heard it a million times.
I told Repo about it, and he and I said, but we're not supposed to talk about
like
it.
But he said not
true.
And he said, because he thinks that you'll think that it's not true, and he's scared to talk about it. And I said, no, that is not the reason we're not supposed to talk about it. It's because he wants to have sex with Drew Barrymore again, and she thinks that if she knows that he's talking about having sex with her, then it won't happen again. And so then he said something like you're very sensitive to like other people, so why don't you extend that to Joe? Like I was being mean to Joe, even though I was just repeating other things he said.
Yeah, the dark repo is really.
But
insane.
I mean, yeah, I don't know. Like it was just kind of one of those like I don't know what you're talking about, and like I didn't get mad at him or anything. It was just weird.
Oh my goodness.
He'd get thoughts.
I kept having all these visions, like, what if, like, he bought heroin and now he failed his drug test, now he didn't think, now he doesn't have a job, and it's all my fault, and I'm like, why is he putting that on me?
Where are you pulling that from?
My head just goes in every situation.
That would not be your vibe, I mean...
But, because once you say, like, I want to buy drugs, you can't get away from that gun.
Yeah, give me a ride home.
So that's
Wait, so what happened? So he drove in a separate car or something?
No, I just left the two of them there because I had to go. It was already, like, 2 a.m.
And did you give Repo a ride?
No, he wanted me to give the drug dealer a ride somewhere.
But Repo had, like,
Repo had a car.
Yeah, but then... I mean, he was wasted, but he drives drunk all the time, and he told me that he slept in his car at Dave Tree, so I kept him saying, I'm just like, go to the room, because he has the keys. You want to get away from this whole thing, but I guess I wasn't a good friend.
I don't know. I don't think that's your responsibility.
I
saved him from it.
Yeah,
I know, I couldn't think of
the story. I mean, that's when he slept in the car in Dave Tree. It's like, I went to see if they're like, you gotta talk. See if your friend's okay, see what's up with him. It's like, well, I didn't, like, okay, I'll do that. But, like, I didn't drive you. And he was like, oh, yeah, I want to hang out. Like, you want to go to the space and jam? I was like, no.
He wants.
I'm not doing, like, I don't, that's not what I want to do at all. Like, I want to drive home right now, and I'm fine to drive home because I think about that and make sure that if that's what I'm doing, then that's what I'm doing. I don't prefer to sleep in my car outside of places. So people do or whatever, like whatever, that's fine. I don't judge anyone for that. And like, and he wasn't putting that on me or anybody else when he was like, oh, I'm gonna sleep in my car or whatever. But like, Pikachu, I had to give Pikachu a ride over there, and then Dave Tree and Pikachu like forced me to sleep over, which is fine.
I got no problem.
It was fun. And
you don't have a problem with anything.
It was very special, you know, but like, I wasn't trying to hang out anymore.
Well, that's another thing, though, too, is that he said that he didn't want to go to the Middle East because he didn't have any money because he got robbed and he didn't want to talk about it.
Wait, Repo said that?
Yeah.
That,
like, somebody stole his money or he got
maybe
robbed
that happened
and he didn't want to talk about it.
Wait, when did he say that?
He said that
Where's my phone?
After the radio.
Well, maybe the drugs.
After the radio? Today he got robbed?
Oh, I didn't ask him when he got robbed because he said that he didn't want to talk about it. He said he got robbed.
Ooh. How does he know he got robbed?
I didn't ask him anything about it. Yeah.
That must have been.
He just said I'm interested in this story when he wanted to talk about it.
Never! Oh, man. Well, yeah, because he just got paid that day.
Oh, so maybe he didn't get robbed.
Unless if that guy robbed him after I left. Because when I said, like, where are you now? He's like, it doesn't even matter. Maybe that's why he was so mad. Maybe the drugs were a dud.
What happened?
Well, maybe that's good.
Yeah, I know.
You
know?
Like, yeah. Drugs.
That's, he learned a lesson. Don't wait. Because he gets paid at the end of the month, so he's gonna have to.
No money.
And no new clothes.
Oh, no. He can't. You've already seen him.
I know. Like, that's something you
need to know. Got a lot, right?
Oh my god, so between that and Tyrone, I'm just. Just so exhausted with keeping him fresh. That and my dad, I'm trying to repair.
You're trying to what? Dad is broken?
Yeah, we've been doing a big thing. I saw him a little bit today. We didn't, well, we didn't really talk as the kids were there. The last time we were going, you guys, not that bad.
We had to sing about the Rock and Roll Show again.
Oh, yeah. I wanted to tell you. But you can't hear it. You can't hear it.
No, it's so nice.
It is
nice. It's so nice to come down here with
a bit. That's like, I think that we should all exchange keys. Steve can come here if the Rock and Roll Show is happening, and then we can go up there if you want waffles.
I wrote that song, I Love
I've never
rock
said
roll.
This too. I had no idea this tree was like a tiny child's flower tree.
It is flaunting your relaxation.
No, the blue one's way more relaxing than beans way back. But this one's pretty nice.
Yeah.
I have another wooden chair I can bring back here. But it's one that I brought to the place. The same that I brought to 10 minutes.
What?
That thing, you remember that wooden chair that I found?
Oh, because it was too big and I wanted
a chair.
So he wanted to put a chair at a desk that I had. It was my house and I had a chair and he was like, sure,
chair. I'm sure.
I like that chair. He just wanted his own chair.
Danger.
I was like,
you know, all kai bang bang.
Excuse me, what?
Yep.
They
welcome
are.
Welcome to what everyone calls you. Behind and in front of your
they're
legs.
So hairy.
And in between your baby legs.
No!
That's right.
Oh, God.
You call those kneecaps? More like flapjacks.
Well,
for a baby.
For you.
Baby flapjacks.
Perfect.
Well, I'm going to have to have a little talk with Herbert.
Look, I'm branding my own.
Well,
show.
I don't want to.
Oh,
talk
yeah,
about
and
that.
You know, if Matt Stearns is your new show.
I was just hanging with her.
Sorry,
yeah. Is he doing Matt Stearns' show?
I think so.
It probably started already. Does he know we're here?
Yeah, I told him we were done. And then he was like, oh, you'll see him now?
Yeah, do you want a very thin, very exclusive cigarette?
Sure, absolutely.
I
really do.
Is it
just
an
exit
like
my cheese? Because you are so special tonight. All the way from Turkish Diana.
Perfect for the window.
Do you even want to admit her?
Do you find Frank's working here?
I don't mind at all. Say no.
I don't really mind a little. Way out of line.
What if you guys all were like, we can't punch
this? Baby, I mean, when she
you like
me
a lot better? Well, that's why I'm in the industry of low five recordings. Steve,
well, you don't even think they're low five.
Welcome, yes. I think you're low five.
Oh,
low five.
Suffering.
Intellect.
You want to know about suffering?
Lo-fi understanding.
Try sitting here next to this.
Lo-fi cognitive.
Next to this what?
Capability. Hi-fi dissonance. Steve Onderich.
True.
Hi-fi
dissonance.
I love Tyrone's impression.
I knew this.
I forget what he was saying in his example.
I have a beard. Then he'll say like one thing that's really like off the wall. Like whatever I think of.
Oh, he said like I take big.
He's like an I take big dog. I like to eat.
Can you try to
speak
it in?
I am.
He forgot. I do it all the time.
But he doesn't go truthful. But like with the Jenny stuff, it's like that stuff was funny, but like it was like, was there a roast organized between like Jenny and Tyrone that I didn't know about? I feel like it was just, it came out of him as like something to say and he didn't like realize that it might be hurtful to be described as the twin sister of Chucky and like a creepy doll that we put on the shelf. Like, I think he
you're
thought,
not a prince.
Like, compliments or something were coming out of his mouth and like. He just wasn't.
Which,
like,
I'm
the message.
I am a comedian.
In what message?
In the message that where she said those things. He said, I'm sorry.
Oh, yeah.
I'm a comedian.
Yeah.
I know not what to
my profession.
Yeah. But it is a little weird. Yeah. Because, you know, it, like. But it's like, I don't know, like, I can't explain your relationship with Jay. I really can't, because I was there witnessing that, and I was like, well, this is kind of weird. But, like, Tyrone's always like, you know, Tyrone has his own relationship with everybody. I can be there to mediate, you know, like, I feel like I should be there for a meeting with you again.
You should just be there.
I feel like I can help with that, because I've been through it.
I don't know, I just, like, I don't want a meeting, I just kind of want... I just no, you know what? What I want, I just want to like hang out with him, not at my house. Like,
yeah.
Well, I just like I don't like it
then he tries to make me hang out with him when I'm tired.
That's the
right.
thing.
Like,
you gotta be.
That's
yeah.
the thing.
So
that's
like
what
I
mean about playing how I would never
care if Tyron was sleeping in a room that I'm in.
Like
even though I really time. Care about that, like everyone else. Like, because I could never, ever feel like I was imposing on Tyron. If I forced myself to wander on for the rest of my life, I would never feel like I was imposing on Tyron.
All right.
Maybe he was referring to one of the tricky sequels that features this doll,
really?
Which is not really a grotesque doll.
It has nothing
it's
to do with the
red
hair.
That's probably
it's
what
like
he meant.
But Chucky does have red hair.
Doll or something. Yeah.
Was she particularly
like Chucky
good?
Is
I don't know.
Horrifying.
I think he might
have
met Chucky.
Yeah,
he's
I know.
Not
I don't know. I mean,
no, he watches a lot of
maybe he has a
white
doll.
But that doll doesn't have curly hair.
What
yeah.
did you
really
write?
I mean, we should ask him about. We should. Where is he? Did some, will you call him? See if he answers your call.
I'll give it a shot. If you share that secret with me, really? Maybe you
want layout.
I have a couple of years.
Yeah. Oh my god, you know, we should write a screenplay where you two, or just do a reality show where you guys have to live in a room and there's like one cigarette in the room. So you have to live there for more.
Well, when I'm not here, I really don't smoke. Like, when I'm not around people who smoke, I really don't.
And whoever smokes the cigarette, like, dies or something.
Like, it's laced with
but like, but, like, we bring them back.
Yeah, and you don't tell us.
Right, I'll put them in.
Yeah. Oh, right. Perfect.
There you go.
Good idea.
Or you're trying to call
maybe you
don't
put a signal
there. Oh.
Stick your phone up
the window. What is it? They have like bars at the top, so I think that would be a signal.
Okay.
You know, use the bars. Probably messed it up your phone. Is your phone down there?
Uh-huh.
Alright, let's see if I have to. Yeah, it's kind of weird. He said he was going to meet us over here.
Did you guys hang out with him after the
raid? Yeah, but.
Yeah,
yeah, we went
over
to Battle Box. Yeah. And I don't know, I think. So, I do this thing where he says, come here, I want you to meet somebody, and I just tell him no. Because I don't like it when he tells me what to do. Just on principle. And so I think that he got sad about that, so then he like just hated me as snow cone and walked away. And
I thought
he
said
hated
me.
He hated me as snow cone, no, he just gave me a snow cone and ran away.
We were expecting
we,
someone.
Someone we didn't see before.
I'm so lost on the stage.
There was a funny moment near the end of us getting there. There's an arcade machine there. But Ninja Turtles at me. I really wanted to play Ninja Turtles.
And I was like,
I'm dying. No, it's his artisan style over in summer.
Oh, rap.
Yeah, yeah. Because they have one arcade machine. There's a bunch of games on that. Anyway, we played for like 3 or 4 minutes. And he was like, giving me all these like weird directions in the game. And then I didn't really that. So I was like, oh, okay, you gotta get that guy. He was talking really fast. And then, and then he said he had a key. And I was
like, I don't know. How about this area that he's not allowed in, that doesn't have a bathroom.
Yeah, did he walk all the way into the shop and back?
Yeah.
Like, into the welding area?
And then you never saw him again?
Upgrading a lake.
Yeah.
No, I called him on the phone and he said he went over to PA's. And then he said he'd meet us up here. Because his cheddar was fucked up.
Everyone's got a spike on the chair
right now.
That's
right.
I think it could mean.
That
was. One of those double words. Like,
what? I mean, you're walking in.
He also, he just like, so, like, I'll come home and this happened one time where I came home and I just, like, told him, like, I wrote him, like, exhausted, I'm really tired, like, and he's just, like, saying, okay, we gotta talk, and then he just, like, he just goes through, like, his weekly schedule, the schedule of his week.
You should have been in a car in New York with us.
And then I was like, you know, Tyrone, like, I really just kind of, I gotta go to bed, and so I just went to bed, and I sort of was ignoring him, because I just wanted to sit on my sofa, and, like, not do anything, and so then I went up, no, and then he wanted me to help him bring a TV VCR upstairs for him, so he could watch VHS tapes, and I was like, Tyrone, I just told you, I'm, like, exhausted. I don't want to do that. Like, can you just try lifting it yourself and just get it upstairs?
Aww.
And he's like, okay, I tried. I can't lift. Okay, it's time to get the TV. And I have no idea how it even happened that I started helping him get his TV. I have no idea how.
You'd be a great cult leader.
That happened.
Like,
and
if he could use his tricks to get things better.
And then at like one point, he only had like a finger of one hand on this TV. carrying it for him.
This is like those stories about like old ladies who are scammed. Like,
yeah.
I don't know how I got to do it.
And so I went in my room. And my room, there's no door on my room, and so I, like, swung the closet door around so that it, like, blocked the door, and then I could hear him say, like, you met, and I pretended I was nobody's home. And then he wakes me up at, like 8 in the morning or something like that the next day. And he's like, okay, I need to talk to you. And so whenever he comes, like, he stands in the doorway, my dog starts barking at him. So he wakes up and he's like wriggling like out of the covers. And he's on top of the covers and he's like at Tyrone.
Tyrone is like that?
Yeah. Tyrone just starts barking. And it's like the ass crack of dawn after I was like, Tyrone, all I want, like, I hadn't slept in like 4 days. And
so
he's like trying to like tell me about the schedule or something and about how we're both going to take the TV and EMF to go on the radio. And I was like, Tyrone, I have stuff to do
today. Oh, that was Tyrone for a second. What's
up?
Does this John Steinbeck do about Tyrone Jones?
I'm putting up podcast while I'm
bleaching.
What's on our bleach?
He's got Lauren Pizza and some random rapper, and they're just talking.
You guys want to hear the Steinbeck quote about Tyrone?
Yes.
He early discovered that a smiling helplessness was his best protection from work.
Mm.
It was easier to do Tyrone Jones' work than to make him good. His mother and father thought him a poet because he wasn't any good at anything else. And they so impressed him with his
very novel
that he wrote glib verses to prove it. Yeah.
Wait, what is this?
This is a Steinbeck quote.
Tyrone.
Yeah.
Talking about
what? Yeah. Talking about a character in the book East of Eden that just reminded me of Tyrone. Tyrone Jones was physically lazy, and probably mentally lazy too. He daydreamed out his life, and his mother loved him more than the others because she thought he was helpless.
That is true.
Actually, he was the least helpless because he got exactly what he wanted with a minimum of effort. Tyrone Jones was the darling of the family.
Crow.
When Tyrone had failed at every job, his father in despair put him to herding 60 sheep. This was the least difficult job of all. And the one classically required no skill, the classically required no skill. All he had to do was save the sheep, and Tyrone lost them. Lost 60 sheep, and couldn't find them where they were huddled in the shade and dry oak.
You guys want to smoke up?
But the key piece is about how, like, it's easier to do their own work.
Oh, shit. Somebody gave me another one of those, like, big fucking fat joints. Should I get it?
I'll miss my fat paper.
Okay. All right.
I'll and I'll shut up. Oh, but then he also, like, he'll stand in my doorway and then talk to me about how, okay, so I talked to my therapist and I'm gonna man up, I'm gonna move out on May 15th and I'll live on the streets, but I'll come back for showers, okay? And Kyle, he's just not talking to me.
Yeah.
Kyle's not talking
to me. He kept saying that maybe I could go back to bed just for showers. He's like, I gotta shower every other day. Someone that's when you
Oh, that's why he's asking you where you're gonna shower.
So where is he gonna? Well, last time I saw him, he had those papers for a free apartment.
That's the other thing is, like, I know that he knows that he has an apartment lined up, but he's gonna tell me that he's gonna be homeless.
Yeah.
And I don't know, I don't know what his motivation is for doing that. And I was just like, Tyrone, like, you have a free place to live. Just find a place to live.
$250 worth of food stamps. Sign me up for this Tyrone lifestyle. Free apartment, free food. And obviously you can all sleep all over him, obviously. I can't touch anything. Interesting.
What is this?
It's
I got so mad. I was like, how did Travis get in here? When I first saw this,
Travis,
and then I was like, I guess I have to let drummers exist. But they infuriate me!
I knew it would, too.
I know. You were like, can there please be a drum set?
I knew
it
would be an issue.
Yeah, of course there can be a drum set. And then I saw it.
You know, he actually did it.
We gotta put that away every time.
Every now and again, I think of myself.
Over.
But
yes.
It's just so horrible, isn't it?
I don't know. I wonder if there's like a thing that we can make that will make it away.
I have my bed.
It could be less horrible.
A better bed somewhere.
If there's still an angel.
But do you have any sense of organization whatsoever? Finally, no.
Well, it's what.
That's why you're heavily restricted.
What if they were not
teach you?
I put them far.
You gotta contain yourself. Did you label this tape? This tape label?
We gotta do. You see, like, an out of line. You're like the new Tyrone for me. No, we haven't even started this tape because I want to be the quote. You're tearing. Everyone loves this pattern. Yeah, we did Pittsburgh.
Try it, Kat.
I don't
know.
Okay, we'll start.
Are you okay, Kat?
No, I'm fucking up royal.
Oh, I've been in Newark, too.
Right.
He says that Daniel Pagan had a party. I don't know.
Why didn't he tell us about that?
I don't know. He mentioned it to me.
Could he be angry at us?
I think it starts
maybe.
Me.
Oh,
you know,
oh wait.
I'm
number one. Did you guys find him up there in the asylum after we left?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I thought you might have just ditched him and then that would have been fucked up.
Is it making any
yeah,
sense?
Yeah, sorry
to
for,
or
like,
Roxbury,
what time is it?
It's like
11:40.
Yeah.
Well,
yeah,
I
think
Roxbury. Oh, Tyrell's party. Time to eat. Yeah.
Oh, but Daniel Pagan
no,
is in Roxbury.
No,
she's awesome. Yeah.
I should just bring her. What are you talking about? Two different parties?
Yeah.
See, how popular
Totem? Is that Totem? Is that Totem?
Is that yeah.
Totem? Totem Bees.
Steve, that's
Totem. Thank you.
Totem. Yep, that's the guy.
Totem, weren't they digging the name?
Friends on Facebook.
Yeah, I mean.
He played with me in the Frankazoid at the end of
it. Like, I thought I would really hit them. He was like a big dad. And
I know.
When I sat down to talk to him,
sir, you seem like such a
different than us. Yeah, he's the epitome of that bearded, like, faux shaman look I was talking about.
Yeah, you'd think that this
guy
would be like,
he looks very
you
different
he
than
bullshit,
he is. Except to have you seen his music.
I've seen his music.
What is
it, right? But if you talk to him, like, he's actually like, really thoughtful.
Yeah, I like it.
Yeah. But yeah, they're going to. So to
Like, I got a mic set up by the. Yes, I am.
Compliments of my mom, number one social media
there streamer. Is there nothing on there?
Let's do it. I don't know. She just said, "Do you want them? They're really gross." And I said, "Yeah," but then I was like, "Why did I say yes?"
You're gonna love them.
You guys gonna be around for a while?
Yeah.
Cool. I'll see you guys after.
Okay.
The real definition of one.
Can do.
Now I already made a little heading for it. It's nothing.
These things, where do these things come from?
Thursday.
Future all along. Look at my arm.
What far out?
I thought my veins were looking weird earlier, but this is next level.
More blood.
Oh, alright. This one has a lot of potential. Oh, this is going to be another good one.
Where's your red skin that's really mine?
What? My big fat one?
Yeah.
I love my
I mean, what?
I might have wrote on some paint with it.
Me too.
That's it might be
good
either.
We got,
but it'll work eventually.
We've gotta like lick it or something.
That probably means something healthy about Ant.
Yeah.
And your lungs.
I can think of something
like that. Yeah. Good thanks. You know, because what have you been not smoking for? Like days on end.
Yeah. Like I no, I actually only smoke
day on. And I come here every day. Sometimes twice a day.
Sometimes
I never leave.
Sometimes. Okay, well that's cool.
That's a blank.
Boom.
Blank to blank.
Leave it as it is. See, I put the
good job. But you got to put it on both sides. Since one side means one side.
Yeah.
Calm yourself.
Anytime
we
above like a
there
depressed
child
people. Oh. Yeah. He loves my eyes. Alright.
He does, he absorbs it. Here's his glands.
I'm in glands.
Yep, you're swimming in that. Blankety blank, blank. Do you want more? We can also put this out. But it is like very fragrant. They always smell like fruit. I guess they're $12 from somewhere, some local dispensary.
Uh-huh. All right. Take a load off, baby. I don't think that's the word. That's the part that I'm really not sure about. Because that's like,
I thought you were singing. Take a load off, baby.
An American girl.
I told it,
yeah. Uh-huh. On a plate. Take a load of family. Make a last moment. She was an American girl. An American girl. Uh-huh. All right.
On Jared.
Take a load off Steven, make a lot of money. She was an American girl.
An American girl. I love his ringlet. I do.
I want to do a whole hair braiding video. Where it's just all hair braiding.
All hair braiding, all on Derek.
I used to like your fishtail braid.
I don't know why.
But I got you. I'm on a rant. I
should have ran. That's what I should have done today. That's what I fucked up and not doing. I am not But I do that. I'll run. I got ready for therapy when I was running late. And I was like, I got there. I was like, I literally ran here. But I'm good about it. You know, because sometimes, like, that's sometimes what it takes me to run in a day. But then once I'm doing it, I'm like, fuck it, I'm running. You gotta do time trial. And then when I back, I don't even realize I'm down. Like when I didn't go to the post office, remember how upset I was?
Yeah. Because you were just so bragging about yourself. I'm so fast. I'm so great.
Well, no, I just didn't realize how quick it is on a bike. So I was like, I don't want to be late. You know? But I had time. Is this my tape?
It's my new loop. Everyone's hearing it.
What are you doing?
It's actually playing. It's playing. I'm doing what?
Well, you made a loop, so you're playing with
the... How dare you with the jazz?
But are you doing it on a boom box?
I told you this ain't it.
Then what's playing on a boom box? Nothing?
Blank.
Oh. I thought it was coming through the boom box. I was trying to figure out what
happened.
Well, what you did, but now
you thought you had a new hit song. Make the song have a distinct over layer feel. Put it all together. Oh, and you were tripping around with your pants around your ankles. I was doing
different because it's just wrong. Whoa. It's just you gotta be able to get through here. He's my front end.
Oh well, yeah.
You know?
I'll hit it anyway.
Even in my athletic wear. It's like you can't step on everything. And lucky for you, I know the difference. Because I could, technically, I could step on
it. I could do we got another foot.
I gave you life. I discovered you. Did you see Tyrone sitting there? Like, he just had this, like, the whole time after Kelsey Rose performed. He was just sitting over there, like.
Did you see him during one of her songs? He was like. Really, like, getting into it. Or I wasn't sure if he was hamming it up.
That's why I said Tom Brady.
Getting into it, or if he really was.
Womanliest woman I've ever met, and that's why I love it.
Yeah.
I mean, Tyrone became my best friend when he invited me to be on an apple party
but
with somebody else's
which
house.
Kind of, which kind of woman
and
is was
he
though?
Because
I feel like
if
he was hamming it up, that one kind of woman.
Apple liquor.
Was,
and I was serious about the plan. Be on apples, we'll just stop.
Look at this giant juice. It's great.
I was like, I need to be there.
St. Louis, you can get like 40 ounce. Cans of beer.
Roll that out of the intruder.
Which, because that's because they allowed like 40 ounce glass bottles there. If you were throwing the street on.
They loved it over there.
This is a quartz.
Where did you get that?
This came from Aranaut Brewery, but it was given to us and the robot area. The robot area didn't want it. So this guy from the wood shop was like, you should drink that. And so I drank
it. And now here I am.
Here I am with it. It's called Pop Pop. So, sweet. Straight from the bearded people of some of the old. Oh, I don't know. So. Yeah, that's what I'm learning is what some of the other people do there is beer, I guess.
It's
just things about it. You know Lauren. Lauren talks really fast.
Pickles?
Talks about how she's a pretty much.
Pickles?
No, not Pickles. That's the other Lauren. Her name's
oh,
Lauren, too,
I'm
right?
I'm sorry, I didn't realize.
Lauren, she's upstairs right now, Lauren.
Have a couple of... I never heard it once.
Lauren, who is a small part of the Devilry Hacker Wars.
You can, like, not make a fortress out of, you know?
A fortress?
There's no me in fortress. Okay. I don't mean we, I mean me, personally.
Well, there's a E. Oh, look, there's something on.
Hey, look at that.
So you can hear the syrupy river.
I'll try a little.
Okay.
You think you're something like a harem?
Harem? Harem? I can't even harem.
I know him. I barely care about
harem. Cause I don't want a harem. Oh! You can fix this joke.
But
and swim.
That'll
send it to Penny.
She'll love it.
I watched a great Fellini movie with a harem scene the other night.
You and me, Penny, were the only ones.
Don't pay any women. I love this gal, but she hates herself.
Oh! And she's red! A self-realized woman!
Yeah.
Woo!
Now, I don't have to hate her, but I do anyway. Oh! She gets bigger nose each time. Okay.
Now,
Okay, cool. Yeah. It's not even here.
Someone's phone.
I didn't know we do that.
Who's phone is that?
I don't know.
Ew.
Okay. Hey, well, we all know.
That's somebody's phone.
It's mine.
It's yours?
It is.
Oh.
I don't know.
You acted like you didn't know that.
I know. I love to play.
That was not my phone. That was deceitful.
Yeah. A cool spot.
First things first.
Come on, man. Get some cool lamps in here.
Are you planning a whole? Hey, you set up that part, Steve.
We had that.
Some of us are hosting an open studio.
I will bring at least one chair up there.
Yeah.
Do you want that chair?
It's actually a decent chair. It's a pretty decent chair, and a Manny still needs it.
Okay.
Well, because of that long
well,
summer.
Well, I don't know if he's gonna want it. Yeah. I don't
know. I didn't know he did. That's why I looked at it.
Yeah, that's right. That people like don't like. Like, I'm used to it, but I don't really think about it. Because, like, actually, one time I actually have that uploaded to YouTube. And then you can cut the best of it. Yeah. Like, but there's no reason not to do that. Like, unless someone wants to sit there and watch the whole thing, great for them. They're doing their own video installation where they want something
or clear
to play for a long time. You have to get to know the internet.
I can get a couple left though.
Okay.
And then I brought my hard drive so I can drag.
So what do you think about putting like hours and hours of video in your life and stuff on YouTube?
When I first saw her playing, didn't know who she was, and then I went online and that's like I just kinda left it on the background. And like it's true, like a haircut videos and I'm like, I was like first time watching the dumb movie, like this is dumb, and then like I started painting. I'm like, I am 45 minutes into this thing.
Yeah, it's like
a different
thing.
Isn't that kind of weird that somebody can just go on YouTube and just like research your life? I don't know why they put it
there.
I assume
they
did. Yeah,
but I've kind of been like, I have some knowledge of what I've put out there. It's not like, I'm fine with that. Like, I don't think anyone is researching me to be like, I'm going to kill you.
Yeah.
Hey,
has
been murdered yet?
What if they say they're going to kill you? They sat down and they're like, alright, excuse me.
Like,
I'm watching all
the
live videos.
They're going to
kill
you. And I'm going to kill you. You know, it's like, the person that gets involved in my life with who I am and watches all my videos obsessively or whatever, like, I don't think they're going
to
want to kill
you.
But I'm not like,
the other day you were talking about
someone, when people like,
and I wouldn't even say who it was, but you're talking about somebody watching something I hate.
What about the
kid who was, because I know what's saying, I don't. Right? You were talking about somebody like looking at a thing on your Instagram or whatever. It's peculiar to me.
Well, it's not
Whenever I think about like collecting and buying stuff, I'm like, well, I'm gonna need this and it's gonna die. But I'm like, but I do want people to have a lot of things. So like, to go through. Oh, now you're in charge of all the movie hours. Wait, say that part?
Well, I think it's almost like a totally different process. Or at least this, like, just setting up a computer, like, and saying, yeah, we're going to have a live stream. It's very different. Technology develops so fast, I feel like an old man, you know. I'm not that old.
But it's not like you're separated. Like you're on the line. Like you're a part of it.
I know.
Just right,
literally.
We're being recorded anyway.
You're not live? Well, you're on social.
Oh, well, maybe. Right, yeah. That's true. Yeah.
And I've made YouTube live on my phone, so you are not with me.
Yeah, I know.
You've been live every possible line that you have a fault, so I know you're
live. God damn it.
Wait for that. I knew it was a side note we weren't in that good. But I knew something like that was cool.
Rhythm.
I know you're praying a little. It's a little bit.
That's actually a
I know your brain.
Kinda just brought that down.
Alright. I don't know what thing. Whatever our next thing is.
Sometimes I'm uncovered with the prospect of editing being live streamed on video. Because I know I'm not a morning person and I'm usually tired.
But you always gotta look at
the editing. Oh my god, did you see what I looked like today? I was wearing.
But you're always ponytailed.
But I was wearing 18 this morning. I haven't showered in 8 years. Like, I've got acne.
Yeah.
You can't
work. I got hairy dad.
Set up horrible.
Yeah. I don't know.
You can't care about.
I don't know, it's a cultural shift, technological shift. You got it?
Kids. I'm like 31 and I'm like reminiscing about like, well, back in my day. We weren't always on video camera.
That's a weird choice on your
mind.
I'm
38
and I'm
like, I
am.
Yeah,
I'm 53 and I can't wait. Yeah, well, I mean, that's good. It's good to be today in the future, I guess.
I don't know, I mean, just, I don't know. I guess, like, what I like about the movie is the craft of putting something together in this
moment.
The contrast between different elements, things like that.
Which, you know, I guess you can still do that.
You know, it's like how it's easy.
At first, you know, yeah, first it's just kind of ongoing. Wait, what did you say? It's a different universe?
It's a, no, it's just a different, like...
Use. A different
that,
use.
You know, it's like, there's TV shows that are... There's TV shows that are sitcoms, and there's TV shows that are practically like, movies, and there's,
yeah.
Like, soap operas, you know, but... TV shows or
talk
shows that go on every night. Yeah. You know, and like they didn't even see the John Carson in the beginning, you know? And it's like there's Howard Stern.
Yeah.
TV, you know, like with film, like film radio exists. It's just film radio. It's important for us to do it. It's way better than we do it, than we not do it.
Yeah.
Like it's like, and that is a big thing. Like anyone that you know can watch Power TV or is just listening to in retrospect, you're gonna watch Power TV, you know, because you get it's documentary style on a basic level.
Yeah.
But it's a total different thing than a documentary and not just audience that's not new.
Yeah.
You know, it's like you gotta worry about what you want to do.
Do you think we're losing
stuff like this? Do you think we're losing like weird art where like an Italian guy wants to do like a great like flashback to his Captain General and wants to do Mad Lady dance?
Well, it's not as mind blowing anymore, but it makes it
the music
stuff seem even better.
Yeah.
Speaking of all the David Lynch movies
are
fun. In Lowell, the cat movie is playing tonight. There's this
what?
Cool.
Today?
Yeah, but.
What else is it playing?
Well, all the David Lynch movies, like the new, they didn't even film it.
The cat movie.
I know, I think we missed it. Like,
what? Why did you even tell me?
I did, I was gonna. I know
you did it! Don't say I did! Oh my god, you're Tom Rose!
No, I remember, like, one night. I think you had a show. Because they only did, they do like random days. I'm like, I better not bring a cat movie. I think it was the night we played Charlie's Kitchen. I was like, I'm going to ask you to
tell me. I'm going to say that I'll tell you that.
What
do you mean? I didn't say today.
No, I just like saw on their Instagram thing. They said, the cat movie is playing tonight.
Wait, it was that day?
Like, they play, like, one movie day on random days, so, like, you would play, like,
Are they gonna play again?
Maybe.
What do you mean by
it? I don't know, they have a weird, because it's a loud act thing. So, like, it's one screen, it's one movie a day. But the theme this month is like, if David Lynch was the piece of that, and then Blue Velvet, like, I'll say in the schedule, like, I settled down. Oh, you wrote down that movie. I really need it.
Oh, damn. Wow. These three end up. Me too.
Lo tenga rilassato.
Quanti anni ha, signore?
40. Ecco, di risultato. Beh, e si prepara di peggio. Un altro film senza speranza.
È la prima volta che fa la cura?
It's never when I want it to be. And then when I'm in the car, I can't see. I can't focus on the road. Papa!
I don't want to see it out. Papa,
no. Not with your daughter around.
Papa, no.
I didn't like it the first time, and I sure as hell like it now. This is Cat Power playing in New York City on May 20th. Webster Hall. A place I've heard of a lot. I think they're like $40. I know, it's part of some festival, but it's just her and some other. But it's like one. I look at the tour and I'm like, well, just come to Boston after. But then she goes to like the Netherlands next day.
What?
I know.
She goes where?
Netherlands. Holland. Dutch pen.
I don't think so, Sean. I don't think so. No, I'm not, guys. What? I'm not playing for this?
What?
Shit. Not again.
She posted something on Instagram while we were talking about it, and she never had the courage to Tuesday night believing that comments. Weird that she she said like if you look backstage it looks like but it's so weird of her Tuesday. Like, I know you mean John Paul
back. I know where it is.
Talking about me, I'm Dr. Phillips. We're talking to you, but one person you control, the next me.
Hello, you.
And then people like they tell out their little problem. I wake up, I drink in the morning, I barely make it to work, then you and me. And I said,
that's
so class. We're not talking
about it. I can't deal with that.
Thank you.
My latest loot. It's just in. I don't know how I got that.
Whoa! What about that other? Did we listen to both sides of that cassette?
Oh, no. Well, I thought you were going to do the raps, dudes.
Oh, shoot.
And then I started the loop up again.
What did I do? Oh, you were like, here's a call from Pop. Awesome.
Oh, right. Oh, there it is.
Yeah.
Oh, I
think I'm talking
come up. Okay. Oh my god, I'm from other
you remember watching
4 days left.
Oh.
Did you record the...
I have a thing where we can listen to you. I don't know what I was
doing. Did we lose the best one?
Well, 4 days left, shouldn't it?
Oh no, this is the one. 3 days left.
Oh my, let me get it.
Eric left.
I don't know if I remember this.
Oh,
the wrong one. Oh. Oh, yeah. You really hear the vocals in this thing.
Oh, wait, this might be good. Oh, yeah. It's a different one. We lost the other one.
What are you doing? Wait, how many? That's all that's left?
Yeah.
Oh, wait, that's... But didn't you put it on your YouTube?
Yeah, but it wasn't a perfect recording.
Yeah, I gotta go get a wire, get to those racks.
But those were on the same day.
Così dico meglio in generale. Hai saputo di me, di Tina, no? Tina? Beh, stiamo aspettando l'annullamento, ma è per questo che si vede che noi due siamo fidanzati. Tanti auguri. E bravo Guido, che stai preparando? Qualcosa di bello? Certo è il posto ideale per pensare a te, lo scrittore per me e la signorina, come sono? Gloria Mori.
Finisci di conoscerla, sono il suo grande ammiratrice.
Lei mi lusinga. Beatrice, la signorina, ho visto da qualche parte la sua fotografia.
Attrice? Sì, ho delle ambizioni in quelle direzioni. Nella verità, ambizioni enormi, ma questo è tutto per un momento.
È laureata in filosofia, permette il Mario un mezzo piacere.
Non laureata, sto solo preparando i miei tedici, un po' di differenza.
L'argomento?
Oh, un argomento difficile. La solitudine dell'uomo moderno nel teatro contemporaneo.
Interessante come tesi, no, professore?
E le capricciose apparizioni di questa ragazza della fonte cosa vorrebbero significare? Un'offerta di purezza, di calore al suo protagonista? Di tutti i simboli che abbondano nella sua storia, questo è il peggiore, imbevuto di amore.
Meglio così.
Così non c'è male.
Ci fa quello che ti conosco,
credo, ma tutti quei bagagli
hai portato. Sono 5 valigie. Dai, Agnes, ti recupero tanto posto. Ne ho portato una, vedrai. Hai caricato tutto?
Ma Carla, qui la sera si va a dormire, sai, non succede mica niente.
Beh, la grande stazione climatica alla moda, ci sarà pure qualche sfilata, qualche localino anche nel nostro albergo, no?
E lui come sta?
Benissimo.
Mi trovo
fatto
bene. Come dai? È proprio lì davanti.
Ben ora. The story's got old.
Come ti avevo detto, non è.
I got tricked when they go a couple years ago. All right, so we just get your phone.
Oh, I'm sorry. Don't you do it.
You picked up
all the drama. drama, please.
I know, you're like, I gotta start a mini. I'm the only person that gets along with them. It's going too good.
I need to sabotage you. No, I'm very grateful to not have you.
Every time I try to do something, I'm up.
Questo quanto ho cercato tutto, va
It's like Jiffy Pop. And then when you eat it, you're like, I have a lot in a long time. I think I saw a video. I remember I'd like
several videos of me making TikTok. Only one time in my life. That's the only time in my life I've ever made TikTok.
You never did
it
in your childhood?
I'm a deprived child. I've never been skinny neither.
You never been oh yeah. Me neither. My mom would get it, but she'd act like it was the biggest thing. Like, oh, you know, like I probably thought
they
it was expensive.
They never even told me about it.
Did you ever have blue popcorn when you were a kid? That was my favorite thing ever. They took it off the market. They had like blue and green artificially colored pop. Take it from the top. And we're rolling. You know, like, I think those are the wrong words. We're trying to do it as a style. Turkey so you have the main words.
That's your space.
I know. I even have my own space.
I'm
like a real artist.
Insulation room.
We're ripping these off.
And we're ripping off the bottom.
About how Tyrone came with it. Can't wink or yeah, ask him to wink. There's no off.
Am I able to sit or
you
in my
yeah, no.
Yeah, so what?
I'm going to get this mid-chair and a semi-regular chair.
You didn't go upstairs to her sister, did you?
Not yet.
Okay. I thought you were hurt because her was just like, yeah,
oh,
why? And I said, why? Just the letter why. And I forgot about that. So, I should look in my book. Oh, wait, they didn't see that. I guess.
Like,
I was trying to show her all that, and I was like, what's your favorite song? And she was like, I like that song, Happy. And I'm like, by Pharrell? And I was like, okay, I'll try to sing it. And she was like, those aren't the words. I was just making them up.
Well, you did the roof thing.
And I know there's no roof. That's
what you said. Yeah, a room with no.
And that is...
That's why all houses are sick.
Why is that a beach roof?
There had to have been built, and I they're pitting the roof. What song is this made of?
This is all I can do is crap.
Oh,
but I'm going to change all the flowers for my
husband. So we get to the papa song. Singing that song at the mall. And, I think that's me and Tyrone. We have to rip those. Tyrone was there when you moved to
college.
It was like some porno song.
Yeah.
you're like, you're dancing with the lyrics and not filthy. Sometimes you can get around with it.
That'd
be it, but you're just
like,
the entire world was like,
that can't.
Okay. He was very upset.
I know, I'm not going to meet with
I can try to count. It's Wednesday.
But sure.
Okay, wait. Not even around.
No, but I'm just skipping around with people. Well, if you want to do a castle, but something hurts.
You're not dragging on the
That's good.
Oh, oh, this is... Okay, we'll be right back. Oh wait, that's
the best fade out. You can't.
I feel like the song's like, this is now. You cannot allow this.
I think Tyra needs that like material so we can get over it, you know? She needs the song. It's like, just so that he can.
No one's like, no.
Hallelujah.
I don't know if you're right.